take me back to Cuba. Enjoy this next adventure. I'm going to share some clips and videos of my adventures in Cuba.
This is Cuba, y'all. Don't you get off the boat and explore.
Funny story. So, you know, the Americans couldn't visit Cuba. So I remember one time me and my daughter and my son, we went to the wax museum and I whispered in Castro's ear, please let us come to Cuba. And voila, I ended up here. So when Cuba opened up to the Americans, I made sure I took that first trip over just in case they changed their minds or closed the borders or, you know, had their little political issues with the Americans. I made sure I got over there. So what I did was I booked a cruise with Norwegian. I cruise with them very often with my kids. So I was like, let me book a cruise with them. We stayed overnight, I think 2 nights, 3 days. So we were only there for 3 days and we stayed overnight 2 nights. So I just booked it. And at the last minute, I found someone in my travel group to go with me. So that's how I ended up in Cuba.
And we driving down the street. Hard, y'all. Okay, I can't make this up. Taxi with Michael Jackson.
Hey, what's up? Vale, puedo hablar, no estoy manejando.
All right, so the first day we got off the boat, and when you get off at the port, there are like a lot of taxis and things out there. So the person that I went on the cruise with that I found in the group, she was a little scared about getting in the car with the taxi. Like, she didn't trust the people. And I was like, well, what are we going to do? Because we don't know nobody in Cuba, so we're going to have to get in one of these cars. Like, so, you know, to make her feel comfortable, we just picked
totally off.
Well, I could have picked anybody, but she, you know,
yeah,
she wanted to
pick someone
that she felt comfortable
with. I like
this a lot. So, we found a tour guide and a taxi, and they took us to the park. We went through caves, we went to the tobacco field, and then we had dinner. So we had a pretty good day. I enjoyed myself. The people were wonderful. I know the trip, it was from the port. I think we had to drive maybe like 3 hours. I believe it was like 3 hours.
Get my horsey. I gave you a nice little rug.
So it takes you 7 months to make a cigar.
but the other process is a year and a half.
Yours is 3 years.
Oh, here is a year and a half. In a factory, it's 7 months.
You're taking more time.
That's what I thought. That's why I'm thinking.
Okay, y'all. He about to roll
out.
Just for my personal purposes, not anything, you know, important.
He's about to roll out.
We call it chaveta. It's a really Cuban instrument. We cut it like this, this, this. It's just the shape.
So we are watching true Cuban cigars being made in Cuba. How crazy is this? Oh, this is awesome.
And we take the filler. The filler depends on the size you want to make. Mm-hmm. Bigger, shorter, fatter, you know.
So the filler is the same as the leaf?
Yeah, the middle leaves.
The middle leaves.
Because they take off the nicotine.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. And this is the central nerve. So we remove it before rolling.
You know it's going to be on Facebook. I'm going to tag you in it.
He's rolling that thing up.
See you weed smokers out there. Y'all can't roll like this, huh?
Oh, my God.
I need to start getting
That's
you guys.
That's not me talking, y'all.
Oh, sorry. I shouldn't say that. I'm putting it on Facebook. You're right.
That is not me talking.
I mean, I don't smoke weed, so I'm not trying.
I don't either, y'all. Okay?
Let me
show
you.
That ain't what I do.
See, I should never drink alcohol.
They rolling up a cigar. And you really telling on yourself, but I'm talking over you. Okay?
Use a piece of paper to take out the humidity.
The humidity?
I'm sorry, the humidity.
Okay.
And the cigar has to stay here for 1 or 2 hours.
Okay.
Use a piece of paper.
One to 2 hours, I gotta say.
Finally, we take the final wrapper leaf, which is already cut. This is the shape.
And roll it.
And we roll it here for the last time.
And there you have a cigar. A real Cuban cigar.
Yep, that's how they do it in Cuba.
And we sell it with honey. So we add some honey at the top, and we take another piece of plate and we put it here to sell it like this.
Oh,
it's
okay.
More natural and less chemical processing.
An organic cigar.
And
after we made our cigars, we went to get something to eat. This place was also at the little park area. So we were able to view nature, sit there, chill out, relax. We had a good day. And since we have a long ride back, we had to get us something to eat, use the restroom, and do all that good stuff. So all to say, we had a successful day. The tour guide and the taxi driver took care of us. The next day, I went out solo. I met another driver. His name was Fidel, and he took me out to dinner. It was like dinner with the Cubans, and it was so cute because he treated me. He bought my food. I was like, wow. So that was really, really nice. So Mr. Fidel took us out, well, took me out, and then I think that day we left at like around, I want to say 5 or 6. So it was time to go, and we were selling off. But Cuba is definitely a place that I would revisit numerous times. I needed more time. 3 days wasn't enough, but it was good for me. I hope you enjoyed the vlog, YouTube. Until next time, peace. Selling off, and we're having dinner. Bye, Cuba.